Welcome to Rekombu, it's Basil here, and today we have the privilege of being in Earls Court, London for the Samsung Galaxy S3 launch event. Now, the Galaxy S3 is the latest flagship from Samsung, following on the huge success of the Samsung Galaxy S2, which was a best-selling Android handset here in the UK of 2011. The Galaxy S3 builds upon the fantastic Galaxy S2 by not only adding a quad-core processor, but improving the screen, bumping it up to a huge 4.8 inches. It's a 720p Super AMOLED display. It isn't Super AMOLED Plus, however, at this resolution you really aren't going to notice. It's vibrant, bright, and literally is popping right out at us as we swipe through the menus of the new user experience that Samsung have created. Taking a look at the hardware, and we can see on the fascia, it's a very nice flush fascia with just one physical home button. Two capacitive buttons sit either side. As you can see, they're both backlit. To the left-hand side is a volume rocker, while to the right-hand side is a power button. Still no camera button, unfortunately. However, Samsung do boast that this has a fantastic 8-megapixel camera on board. Up top is a 3.5mm headphone jack and a little dock where you can pull open to reveal the battery, which we can do. You can see it's locked in place, but you've got a removable battery there and a micro SD card slot as well. You've also got a micro SIM card slot. Now, you want to bear in mind that you can get the Samsung Galaxy S3 in three variants: 16 gigabytes, 32 gigabytes, or 64 gigabytes. If you're to opt for the 64 gigabyte option and add a 32 gigabyte memory card, you can get a total of 96 gigabytes of internal memory on your mobile phone in your pocket. We think you'll agree, that's pretty amazing. As you can see, the new UI is customized to be more like nature, at least that's what Samsung keep on saying, or kept saying in their keynote. If we tap the screen, we'll get a ripple. If we tap and pull, we'll unlock the phone. As far as the camera goes, the UI has been kept very, very similar to what we've come to expect in the S2. It's a very attractive UI, and the customizable shortcut icons on the left-hand side are present. There are a whole host of shooting options with a maximum resolution, as we mentioned, of 8 megapixels. Switching over to video, and we have a full HD video capture device in our hands. We're glad Samsung didn't up the resolution to 12 megapixels, as we can see on the Sony Xperia S, for example, the resolution bump up does mean more noise. So the Samsung Galaxy S3 should deliver decent noise levels, at least better than the S2. Finally, the front-facing camera is also able to shoot in HD, so you can share all your memories in Skype and FaceTime, well, that's the iPhone version, to your heart's content. So that has been a very quick overview of the Samsung Galaxy S3. Thanks for watching Rekombu. Stay tuned for more on this handset and a full review coming your way shortly.